Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Friends, welcome back to my channel. While working on adjustable power supply, I was facing a problem that power supply was not adjusting the voltage. Because it is microcontroller-based, processor-based power supply, so it is digitally controlled. I found this optical encoder, which is used to increase the voltage, and the second one was the current. So it was not adjusting the voltage. When I checked output signal, channel B and channel A, there was no output. It is 64 pulse per rotation encoder. It generates 2-bit data, channel A and channel B. And phase difference between channel A and channel B will determine the direction of rotation, clockwise or counterclockwise. If the channel A is leading, then channel B is lagging, that means rotation is clockwise. If channel B is leading, channel A is lagging, at that time the rotation is counterclockwise. And how much speedy we are rotating, it will generate the same speedy pulses here. It is 5 volts supplied. The problem why occurred, that's the 5 volt supply in that power supply, because there is a microcontroller processor, so that needs 5 volt power supply. So that 5 volt power TTL power supply was uncontrolled, so that damaged this encoder. It was not generating the pulses, so we need 5 volt plus minus 0.25 volt. It is 5 volt power supply, so we will connect it. When you want to test it, how you will make connections for best operation, best function testing. Here we have 6 pins. If you place in this way, the first pin here, that is the ground pin, the negative power supply, ground power supply. Second pin, that is channel A. Then it have 2 pins in the center that are left blank here in this model, because it don't have a push button. The same packing, it have another model that is using push button. So in that case, push button, push switch will used here, that is micro switch. Then we have positive supply, the second last from the right side, and the last pin at the right side, that is channel B. When you want to connect it for test purpose or for normal use, channel B will pulled up with 1 kilo ohm resistor. Channel B to positive supply 1 kilo ohm resistor, channel A to positive supply 1 kilo ohm. So 1 kilo ohm resistors will connected between both channels to the power supply. And we need 22 nanofarad capacitor from channel B to ground and channel A to ground. This is the ground, channel A positive, channel B. One resistor from channel B to positive, channel A to positive. One capacitor from channel B to ground, channel A to ground. We have 2 capacitors, 2 resistors. And we need 5 volt power supply. So it is exact 5 volts. We will connect ground, positive supply to the positive pin. And we will connect oscilloscope, channel A to channel A. And we will connect ground here. Channel B to channel B. And ground pin to the common. So the connections are complete. So it have pulled up signal. It is not generating signals. So this is the faulty component. Its part number is EM14A0D C24L064. So let's change this component and then we will see the result on the scope, and I will change that component. Now I have this new piece EM14A0D C24L064. The part number must be the same which we need. Now we will connect in the same way. I connected the wires here. Channel B positive, this 1 and 2 for push switches. If your switch is with push button, at that time we will use pin 1 and 2 the center pins for the push button. This one is channel A and this one is ground. The yellow wire, that is ground. Now we connect it the same way. Ground to channel A, 1 capacitor, 22 nano. Ground to channel B, 22 nano. Positive to channel A, 1 kilo ohm. Positive to channel B, 1 kilo ohm resistor. 2 pull up resistor and 2 bypass capacitors. And now I will connect power again. Ground here and positive here and I will connect the ground pin to the ground, both channels, channel A to channel A, ground to ground, and channel B to the last pin. Now I connected all connections. I connected the knob and I will fix it here so that we can move it freely. Yes, this is now clockwise rotation. This is a good indication. Our last signal, it was not displaying good. I will stop it. Okay. This is the starting edge. If we see the channel 1, this is leading edge. The signal is starting from here. And after that, the channel B is starting. So channel A is leading. When it have clockwise rotation, channel A will lead and channel B will lag. I captured another time. We can see now channel A is leading. It is coming before channel B. Okay, now we will rotate it left side counterclockwise. I will take one sample. When we were rotating it clockwise, at that time channel A signal was leading. That was starting before channel B. But now if we see the starting edge, the rising edge of channel B is before, and yellow signal, that is channel A, is after that. So in this way the processor will become to know that the channel B is leading, so that the rotation is counterclockwise. How much rapidly it is moving, it will determine the number of pulses in specified time. And the pulse duration, that will determine the increment, because it is incremental decoder. So in this way it will detect the rotation. Now our this encoder is good, so I have to install this one. Now I will install this encoder. The original one was missing signal. Processor cannot define which signal is coming clockwise or anti-clockwise, so it have to differentiate the rotation side, increase or decrease. So I will fix it in the system so it will work. I hope so this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, let me know in the comment box. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.